Greetings. This is Pastor Roosevelt Milford from Waterford Ministry International in Miami, Florida. This is praise and worship. And let us bow our head with me in prayer as we begin our worship. Father, we bless your name today. We give you all the thanks, all the praise, all the glory that you deserve. We ask, Father, that you'll fill our heart today with gratitude and reverence as we come before your presence this day. Father, we pray that your presence will be felt in this place as we seek to glorify you, give you all the praise that you deserve. Guide us through our worship and inspire us to grow in our faith. In Jesus' name we pray. Scripture says in 2 Chronicles 5, verse 13 and 14, it says, in unison, when the trumpeters and the singers were to make themselves heard, with one voice to praise and to glorify the Lord, when they lifted up their voice, accompanied by trumpets and cymbals and instruments of music, and they praised the Lord, saying, he indeed is good, for his loving kindness is everlasting. Then the house of the Lord was filled with a cloud, so that the priests could not stand to minister by reason of the cloud. For the glory of the Lord filled the house of God. Father, I ask that you fill this house. In the name by the blood of Christ Jesus, we pray. Amen. Let us worship the Lord.
See you. You're all those things to us, Lord. For all of us in this room tonight, you're our shield, strength. You've been my portion since I can remember you. Strong and mighty tower. I run into your name again tonight, oh God. You are my shield, my strength, my portion.
Thank you.
that sound.
Nations will come and bow down.
to sing beautiful love songs, simple love songs like that to you. To express our hearts in worship. To give our hearts wholly back to you, Lord. Following hard after you.
Hallelujah to the Lord.
Yeah.
Thank you. Hold deep is the Lord.
came to worship you. I came just to sing your praise. I came to love you. Your holy name to reign.
Scripture, the last song that we heard says, I came to worship you. I came to worship the Lord. That's why we're here today. You're not here for me, and I'm not here for you. We are here to worship the Lord. And guess what? Not only to worship him, but to worship him in the spirit of truth, right? Let us bow our head in prayer. Holy Spirit, we welcome you in this place. We thank you for your presence. Father, we bless you. Jesus, we love you. And we thank you for this ministry. We thank you for all that you have done for us here and all that you will be doing for all our ministries overseas. And we bless your holy name, Lord. We are very grateful to be here this morning, Lord. It's not like we are better than everybody else, but it is your grace, it is your mercy, it is your love, it is your favor, Father, toward us, Lord Father God. We didn't do anything to deserve it, but remember you loved us before the foundation of the earth. Our name is written in the book of life, and we thank you for that, Lord Jesus Christ. And we just pray for the others that has not come to that point of receiving you yet, that you will bless them, Father God, that you open their eyes of understanding so they can see you as we see you, as we ourselves see you daily, Lord. And we bless your name, Father. We give you thanks, we give you praise, we give you glory. Scripture says, who can stand in the hill of the Lord unless he has a clean hands and a pure heart? Father, we come before you this morning, this day, this afternoon actually, and we bless your name. We confess to you, Father, every known sin, sins remembered, sins forgotten, sins of the flesh, sins of the tongue, sins of the thought life, all that we have done and failed to do. Father, we renounce every secret sin that is hidden in us and everything that grieves your Holy Spirit. And we ask for your forgiveness. We ask that you would cleanse us, purify us, Lord. Mold us, shape us, make us into your image and likeness. We pray for a pure heart and a willing, steadfast spirit to sustain us. And we bless your name, Jesus. We give you thanks, we give you praise, and we give you glory as we take the cleansing of your precious blood. We present our body to you this day, Lord. Each and every day as a living sacrifice, as a reasonable service unto you. We present our members as an instrument of righteousness. We give you thanks, we give you praise, we give you glory, Father. We thank you, Father. Scripture said, in you we live and move and have our being. It's all about you, Jesus. It's all about you. And we bless your holy name, Lord. Father, we lift up the members. We lift up the ministry. We lift up all ministries, all Waterford Ministry International, the pastors are before you, Father. And we pray for them. We pray, Father God, that you will bless them, that you will protect them, as well as all ministers of the gospel. And we pray for all apostles, teachers, evangelists of the Lord Jesus Christ, that you put a candle of fire in their tongue so they can preach the gospel of truth throughout the world. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. We give you thanks. We give you praise. We give you glory. We pray for our health, safety, welfare, travel by car, our boat, planes, our body parts, systems, organ, structures, and function. Covered with your precious blood of Christ Jesus. Father, we pray for our nations. We pray for every nation of the world, Jesus Christ, because they all belong to you, Jesus. You are the creator of heaven and earth. We know that you're in control. We ask, Father, that you change those things that need to change. There are things that we have no control over. But you do have control over it. All it takes is a simple prayer. And we ask him to set the captive free. There are people in bondage. There are people that have been held as slaves. There are people that are suffering. There are people that are sick. There are people that are lost and cannot find their way. There are nations in uproar, and there are, Father, wars. Only you can take control of that. Only you can bring an end to it. Only you can bring peace to your nations. Only you can speak for the Israelite in the conflict that is going on all over the world. Father, we bless you. We give you thanks. We give you praise. We give you glory. We take authority over Satan. And we bind you, Satan, every unholy cherubim from dominion, seraphim, archon, archon parasites, watchers, nephilim, small and large great aliens, and all aliens, entities, powers, rulers of the darkness, wicked spirits in outer space, and all territorial spirit, elemental, strongman spirit on assignment, all above, around, and below the strongman spirit, yelled above, all who project, all walk-ins and log-ins, all shadow people, invisibles, men in black, we bind and break your communication line, supply lines, bind up and off, all reinforcements and casting you out, sending you to the pit, chain you there until the great white throne judgment. We bind Leviathan, Orion, Behemoth, the marine spirit, Python, Ahab, Gaia, Antichrist, false fighting spirit, every spirit, none of the Holy Spirit, all above, around, and below. We are loose and you are cast out. We take authority. We break your powers. Bind your threefold cords, enabling, and casting you out, sending you to the pit, chain you there until the great white throne judgment. We give you thanks, praise, we give you glory. We bind up and off all retaliation, counterattack, reprisal, wrath, revenge of Satan to or through any individual organization's adversary, would be adversary from this day. Any day past, any day to come, decree such forbidden, all immediately, completely, permanently, perpetually, immediately, in the name of the blood of Christ Jesus, we cancel every argument in the spiritual realm. In the name of the blood of Christ Jesus, we pray. Father, we bind up all retaliation, and we decree forbidden in the name of the blood of Christ Jesus, we pray. Amen. My brothers and sisters, it is that time in the service where we receive communion. As the scripture said, we are not to receive this Holy Communion in an unworthy manner. We are to confess all of our sins before the Lord. We ought to acknowledge the Lord's works of the cross on our behalf. It should have been me and you hanging on that cross, but Jesus Christ, in his grace and mercy, went from me and you. My brothers and sisters, while they are passing out the communion, please take a moment to confess all of your sins before the Lord.
try to stay away from that speaker, like move further to the side of the room.
How about here?
Yeah, because I'm getting feedback when you're close to that speaker.
The Lord Jesus Christ, on the night he was betrayed, broke bread with the disciple, lift up the bread in heaven and pray and giving thanks to the Father as we now lift it up before the Lord, giving him thanks. Father, we thank you for this bread. Thank you for this cup. We lift it up unto your name. We ask that you bless it, that you would sanctify it, purify it, bless it, make it whole. In Jesus' mighty name we pray and ask that you empower each one of them with the power of the Holy Spirit. Father, this bread alone represents Jesus' body, broken for me and you in Calvary for the forgiveness of sin, that every time we partaking in this Holy Communion, we do it in remembrance of him. We are also proclaiming his death until he returned. Let us eat now in covenant. Let the Lord speak something into your heart. This cup represents Jesus' blood shed for me and you in Calvary for the forgiveness of sin. And every time we do this in unity, one accord, we do it in remembrance of him. And we are also proclaiming his death until he returns on earth. Let us drink now. In covenant, speak something back to the Lord. We give you thanks, Lord. We give you praise. We give you glory for your presence in this place. We bless your name. Scripture says in Luke 6:38, give that it will be giving unto you with good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over. Measure that you use, it will be measured back to you. Brings your tithes, offering, back tithes, special offerings into the storehouse of heaven. And God will surely bless you. brothers and sisters in the Lord, let us lift our hands in this offering. Father, we come before your presence this day, lifting up our hands in this offering. We ask that you make it holy unto you, Lord Jesus. We ask that you will give this godly wisdom, this administration that will be used for your purpose and your glory alone. We ask, Father, that you will give each person here a hundredfold return. We pray for a special blessing over Waterford Ministry here and Waterford Ministry International overseas. We ask that you bless the pastors, bless the members, and bless those hands that was not able to give today. And we pray, Father, that you open doors for them and you bless them also. So they are, when the next time they have an opportunity to give, it will be a blessing for the ministry. We bless your name. We give you thanks. We give you praise. We give you glory, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. In the same, say in agreement. Amen. Amen. Please stand by. Our teaching will begin momentarily.